Welcome back friends. In this video I am going to tell what is JWT and a demo. I have already implemented JWT. It's working fine. The code already committed in the repository. If you want, you can take a look. In the next video I am going to explain code implementation. In this video I am going to explain what is JWT, what is the purpose of JWT and a demo. Okay. The purpose of JWT is authorization. If you take any system, if you take any application in the world, the application must have an authorization part. If any people login into the system should validate the particular login information is valid or not. If it is valid, allow him to further manipulation. Otherwise, the system block him, it never allow him inside the application. That is the purpose of authorization. In Spring Boot, we have several authorization mechanism. I have chosen JWT for my billing system. This billing system is very simple billing system. Intention of developing this billing system is one is for student and job seeker who wanted to gain a project development experience. Second one is I am focusing only small retailers, not for big shot. I am focusing only for small retailer. For them I can provide this version of billing system without cost. Okay, this simple billing system I can use basic authentication, that is simple authentication, but I wanted to use JWT. The reason is in this billing system I want to cover as much as possible Spring Boot technical information. That is the reason I am implementing a JWT. Through this, job seeker or student can learn how to implement a JWT. Okay, now we'll go into the JWT. Let's see what is the purpose of JWT. The expansion of JWT is JSON Web Token. JSON Web Token. JSON Web Token is nothing but it's a big encrypted string. It's a big encrypted string. This encrypted string contains three sections. One is header, payload and the signature. This is that big encrypted string. If you see here, I have differentiated this string in three different color. The first one is a red color, it's a header section. Second one is a blue color, it is a payload section. Third one is a green color, which is a signature section. Okay, why they are calling us a JSON Web Token? If you decrypt this string, you will get one JSON structure. You will get one JSON structure. That JSON structure will have a three section. One is a header, another one is a payload, another one is a signature. Okay. In my user public controller, I have created one endpoint called authenticate, API public / authenticate. Using this authenticate, we can validate given username and password is valid or not. This authentication requires DTO. This authentication requires DTO contains username and password and refresh token. There are three attributes I have given. I will go to explain later. Okay, don't worry about this section. Just I am saying is this authenticate endpoint accept authentication request DTO as a request body which contain username and password. We'll take that username and password. We are authenticating that username and password valid or not. If it is valid, this endpoint return JSON Web Token. Okay, let's see now. Let me open the Postman. Yeah, Postman is opened. The authenticate endpoint I am giving username and password. Username and password is available in my database suresh.customer@gmail.com and the password is 123. When I send request, it will validate this user and I return JSON response if the user is valid. See here, I'm getting some response. See, access token, refresh token, access token expiration, refresh token expiration. When sending authorization, our server returning two different token. It's a one is access token, another one is a refresh token. Okay, then access token expiration date and a refresh token expiration date. We cannot use this token always. Okay, it will go to expire certain time of period. Then we need to regenerate the access token. We have to use. We'll go to see the sentence flow, how this is working. Okay. Before going to explain the flow, I wanted to show you one thing. I want to show decrypted JSON data. After decrypting, I want to show what is the value inside that encrypted JWT token. Okay, I'm copying this. There is a one site called JWT.io. Go to that site. In this site, if you scroll down, there is a two section, encoded and decoded. There is already one JWT default string. Remove that. Paste it whatever you copied from the postman. I copied that here. See, this is a first is a header section. This is a decoded header section. This is a decoded header section. Here you can see ALG colon HF256. Meaning of this is JWT using the HF256 algorithm for encrypting the data. The second part is a payload. The payload, you can see three attributes. One is subject. SUB means subject. Subject always have a username. Whatever username I'm using here for login, that username available here. EXP nothing but expiration, that is when this JWT token will expire, that is the expiration time, you see in the long format. Then IAT nothing but issue date, when this JWT generated, that time in the long format. It has a three attribute. What is a username is a subject, second one is a expiration, it is a when this token will going to expire, third one is a IAT issue date, when this token generated. Three attribute in the payload section. If you want, we can add our additional information also. This payload structure, we can call it as a claims. I'll going to explain about the claims when I explain about the code implementation. Okay, third section is a signature section. The signature generated from combination of header and the payload, combination of two data signature is generating, that is a third section of the JWT token. Okay, this one I want to show you. We'll go to see this entire flow now. So this is a client section, this is a server section. We'll go to see how the communication happening between the client and the server while generating JWT token, while authorizing using JWT token. Okay, the first user should enter username and password, right? Username and password. Server will authenticate the username and password if it is valid. Okay, if it is valid, the server return back to two type of token. One is access token, another one is refresh token. I'll going to explain what is access token, what is refresh token. End of the session, definitely you're going to understand about those things. Okay, once user is valid, our server return two type of token, one is an access token, another one is a refresh token. The client should store this access token, refresh token somewhere else in secure manner. After generating successful access token, going forward, client will use that access token for further request. For example, I have logged in successfully, I got the access token. Now I want to view employee details. I want to view employee detail. To view the employee detail, you don't have to log in again using username and password. You have already access token that given by server. You need to send access token part of each web service request. Each web service request. Okay, for example, in our case, I want to view the employee detail. To view the employee detail, we must have one web service endpoint. Part of that web service endpoint, we need to set this access token as a header value. Okay, then we have to send a request to the server. Server get the access token first. It validate that access token is valid or not. If it is valid, server take the employee information and send back to the client. So each and every request, client should send access token in the header part. So server validate the access token. If it is valid, it returns the respective response. Otherwise, it will give an error. The access token we cannot use always. Okay, some part of time access token will expire. Some part of time access token will going to expire. In that case, your server return your access token is expired. Something like that. It will going to return a response to the client. Now, client should generate new access token. For that, client should use the refresh token. Okay, now you understand what is the purpose of refresh token. Whenever access token expired, client already having a refresh token, they have to send to the server, hey server, my access token is expired, please take this refresh token, validate this refresh token. If refresh token is valid, please send back to new access token. So like that, client should ask. So client sending the refresh token, server validate the refresh token. If the refresh token is valid, server again generate the access token and send back to the client. Now client will going to use the new access token for further request. This is the flow of JWT authorization. Based on this flow diagram, we're going to see the demo now. Okay, the first step, we need to log in with username and password to obtain the valid access token and the refresh token. The postman, I'm using the authentication response. In the authentication endpoint, in the authentication endpoint, I'm passing user.customer@gmail.com and 123. This is the username and the password I'm passing. I want to get the valid access token and the refresh token for this user. Okay. Status is 200. Now the response is, in the response I'm able to see valid access token and refresh token. This information I'm maintaining in the database. Okay, when you look at the database, see here, this access token, the table name is a JWT token. The JWT token I'm maintaining the customer name and it's the customer's access token and the refresh token. Then access token expiration date and the refresh token expiration date. Okay, see, this access token ends with C5X-O. When you look at the response, C5X-O. Also the refresh token YBXU, right? YBXU. See, YBXU ends with YBXU. Both are stored in the database. Now I want to use this access token for further request in our billing system. Now I want to view the employee details. Based on the diagram, next step, if the username password are valid, the server send the JWT token. There are two types of JWT token sent by the server. One is access token, another one is refresh token. We are able to see the both the things in our response. Okay, then third one is for further subsequent request. The client uses the access token. For example, if you want to view the employee detail, the client sends the access token part of view employee endpoint. Okay, and this is my view employee endpoint. If you want to view the employee, I want to send employee ID. Along with that, I have to pass that access token. How do you pass the access token? We need to pass the access token part of the endpoint header. This is a header value. The postman, if you want to add an header, we need to add header in this section. Click the header section, type authorization and select it. Then we need to pass access token. This access token prefix started with bearer. Bearer space, then whatever access token you have, we have to paste that access token here. Okay, these are some other access token. Let's see what's happening here. See, it says forbidden. 403 means authorization request, authorization error. So authorization response, authentication will make no difference. That is that meaning of this forbidden is since it's an invalid access token, our server not allowing to view the employee detail. Now I want to copy this valid access token, then I want to paste that in my header part. One space, copy the access token. Now I want to view that, so I'm able to view. Once you pass the valid access token, I'm able to view the record. Okay. The fourth step is, if the access token is invalid, the server sends an error back to the client saying that invalid token or token expiration exception. It says either invalid token or token expired. Like that, exception will thrown by the server. If the access token is valid, the server sends the employee detail back to the client. We have already seen that when pass the valid access token, I'm able to see the we were able to see the employee record. Okay, now we're going to expire the token. How to expire the token? Go to the database. Access token expiration date is 11/3/1137. Now my time is 10:18. Now I want to make this to 9 o'clock. 09. I'm making as a 09/37 as a expiration date. That meaning I'm updating. This meaning now our token already expired, because here my time is 8:18 a.m. But here the expiration date is 9:37 a.m. That meaning the access token already expired. Now I'm going to copy this, the same access token I'm using already here. Now I'm going to send the request. See here, YC5X0, expiration date is 9 o'clock, it's already completed. Now I want to send the request using this expiration token, say forbidden. Again, it's not allowing to access the data because this token is already expired. Now, if the token is expired, what you have to do? If the access token is invalid, fifth step, if the access token is invalid, the client should request a new access token using refresh token. Okay, if your access token is invalid, the client already have a refresh token. Using refresh token, client can get a new access token. In the database, I have a refresh token. I am copying this refresh token. There is another endpoint called refresh token. Using this refresh token, I can get the new access token by providing refresh token. In the refresh token endpoint, there is a request body. We need to pass our refresh token here. This is our refresh token, YBXU. Ends with YBXU. When you look at here, it ends with YBXU. Now I want to send the request to the server. See, server sending again response with a new access token. See, this is a new access token, BHAM. BHAM is a new access token. This is a old access token, C5X-O. If you refresh this query, we'll see the new one, new access token. Refresh token is the same only. Okay, we are using old one. Okay, now I'm going to copy this. And going to the employee view record. This is the old access token. Let's try with that. See, I'm getting forbidden error because this is an old one. Now I copied a new one from the DB. Make sure that you have to use bearer, one space, then token name. Say now I'm able to get the employer record using new access token. Go back to the picture. If the refresh token is valid, the server send a new access token for further subsequent request. Now we have what we did using this endpoint. We send the refresh token, server provided new access token. Using that access token, we are able to see the employer record. This is the sixth step. The seventh step, if the refresh token is invalid, some cases refresh token also may be invalid. See, both token have a expiration date. Difference between the both is access token should have a shorter life. Access token should have a shorter life. Refresh token should have a longer life. Let's say access token may have 1 day validity. Refresh token we can keep 15 days validity. Okay, using 15 days we can use the refresh token to get the new access token, but our access token should expire within 1 day or 2 days. That we can set based on our requirement. Okay, if the refresh token is invalid, the server send an error back to the client. If refresh token is invalid, server send the error back to the client. The client has to provide username and password for new authentication. If refresh token itself invalid, what you have to do? We need to send a username password for new authentication. Once you provide username and password, it will regenerate a new access token and a refresh token. Okay, now we're going to expire the refresh token. Let's see what's happening. This is a refresh token. The refresh token, the validity is 1244. Okay, the validity period is 1244. Now my time is 8:24. Okay, now I'm going to change it to 9 o'clock. I'm going to updating now and change it to 9:44. But my time is 10:24. That meaning the refresh token already expired now. I'm going to copy the refresh token using expired refresh token. Using this expired refresh token, I'm going to request a new access token. Let's see what's happening. See, it's giving a bad request because since it's invalid, it's giving a bad request. Okay. In such a case, what you have to do? Again, we have to go to authenticate endpoint. We need to provide username and password to get the new access token, new refresh token. So I'll go to request now. See, now we're getting new access token, new refresh token. See, the access token ends with 4LOY. 4LOY, refresh token with VEHZ4. Okay. So we have completed the full scenario. If the username password is valid, the server send a new access token, refresh token to the client. Then client use the new access token for further subsequent request. Now using this particular new access token, I can send a further request for viewing employee for some other activity. So I'm able to get the record now. I hope that you people understand how the JDBT is working in the Spring Boot. If you have any question, please comment me. Definitely I'll going to reply the answers. Okay. In the next video, I'll going to expand the code base. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.